Okay, good morning to all of you. I welcome to all in our lecture series on mechanics, that is your classical mechanics paper, core paper 2, belongs to first semester BSc syllabus. In our last class, we have been discussed about gravitational potential due to spherical cell. What will be the gravitational potential at external point on the surface of the sphere and inside the sphere? In detail we have been discussed, and the variation of potential versus distance and corresponding field intensity versus distance also we have been discussed. So in today class we are going to discuss gravitational potential due to solid sphere. So let's start. Now we have to consider a solid sphere having total mass is m and radius is r, that is belongs to your figure 1. I have to write it a little better. Figure 1 means this one, figure 1, whose radius, this radius is r and the mass, total mass of this sphere is m, having density, that is your mass by volume, that is total mass by volume, that means 4 by 3 pi r cube, let it is rho, this symbol is rho, okay, but this symbol is sigma, this is your surface density, this is volume density, okay, surface area density. Area, surface area density, this is your volume density, this is sigma, this symbol is sigma, this symbol is rho, remember it, okay. Now m will be equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho, let it is your equation number 1. And the solid sphere here the solid sphere is assumed to be made up of large number of thin uniform concentric spherical cell. This line is important that you have to understand. Suppose we are going to consider this is a solid sphere, then this solid sphere is made up of large number of thin uniform concentric spherical cells. Actually, how it is, you just consider this is a spherical cell which will be made up of large number of solid sphere which is made up of large number of spherical cell. How it is? See, this is solid sphere, okay, solid sphere. You just concentrate at the center. This will be a small spherical cell. Then another spherical cell we can found over that small spherical cell. Then another, I can show you like this. See, this is at the center, this is small. Then above that, another cell will be there like this. Thin cell. Then another cell like this. Then another cell. Then another cell like this. So this will be made up of large number of cells, concentric cell. Concentric means having one center. Large number of cells, but concentric means having common center. All the cells have common center. So this is one cell, over that cell another cell we can consider having very thin thickness, and over that another cell like this. If I am going to consider, then it will be a solid sphere, right? So this is the concept behind this line. You just imagine, which will be help to understand the derivation. Okay. Now we have to consider to finding the potential due to this solid sphere at point which is the external point of this solid sphere. Here we have to find out the potential. Let P be a point outside the solid sphere at a distance r from the center, that is OP equal to r, as shown in figure 1. Consider a cell of radius x and thickness dx, so that the volume of this cell will be surface area into thickness. The surface area will be how much? Will be 4 pi x square. The surface area of this cell will be 4 pi x square, because this is your radius of this cell, and this 4 pi x square will be surface area, and thickness will be your dx. So hence volume will be 4 pi x square dx. Now if the volume of the cell will be this one, then what will the mass of the cell? Mass is nothing but your volume into density. So here volume is 4 pi x square dx into density is rho. So mass of the cell having the radius r, thickness dx, will be 4 pi x square dx into rho. Then the gravitational potential at point P due to this spherical cell will be or is equal to dV equal to minus g mass of the cell divided by distance, right? So here distance is r, g is constant, minus mass we found this one. Here I substituted and we found dV. This dV is nothing but your potential due to the spherical cell having the radius r at point P, which is distance r apart from the origin. From the origin, this P has the distance is small r, and the mass of this spherical cell will be 4 pi x square dx into rho. So hence dV potential due to this spherical cell at point P will be this much. Let it is your equation number 2. Now gravitational potential at point T due to the whole sphere can be obtained by the integrating equation number 2. This line is important. So here we found this dV is nothing but due to only one cell. That here we discussed large number of cells is going to be overlapped with each other, overlapped like this, then we found a solid sphere, right? So here we consider this is the origin, this is the point P, and this is your R, right? Here we consider a arbitrary cell, this one. We have been considered an arbitrary cell whose radius is x and thickness is dx, and we found the mass is 4 pi x square dx, and due to this cell at point P, the potential will be this much. So for the whole sphere at point P, the potential will be how much? We have to integrate all the cells. That means first we have to consider this cell, which is exactly at the center. From how much the potential? Then next cell, then next cell, then next cell, then next cell, up to radius r. That means summation of dvi from O or from center to surface, or the radius varies from 0 to r. the radius varies from 0 to r. That means I equal to 1 to n, we don't know how many cells is going to be considered that can be made, that will be made up of in such a way that we are going to get the spherical sphere. Suppose that is n. So if we are going to add all the potentials considering all the cells, then we are going to find out the potential at point P due to whole sphere. Okay, now what will be the integration? Integration will be, if I am going to consider the cell which is exactly at origin, then what will be the radius of this cell which will be exactly at origin? See, if we are going to consider this cell, the radius is how much? X, right? I am going to zoom somewhat. If I am going to consider this cell, the radius is how much? X. If I am going to consider the cell which is exactly at the center, then X will be how much? 0, right? The cell which is exactly on the surface, then what is the radius? X will be equal to R. So the limit will be how much? Here, the gravitational potential at point P due to whole sphere can be obtained by integrating equation number 2 from 0 to R. So exactly at center, the radius of the cell will be 0. The cell exactly on the surface, the radius is R. So we have to integrate 0 to R to find out the potential at point P due to whole sphere. Okay, so you just integrate these minus g 4 pi rho by r constant taken outside 0 to r x square dx, it will be x cube 3 0 to r, and just substituting upper and lower limit, we found minus gm by r. Let it is your equation number 3. So here gm is constant, so it is inversely proportional to r. If r will be increased, the potential will be is going to be decrease, the magnitude of the potential is going to be decrease. So here I am going to suggest to all of you, last class also I told that draw the figure perfectly. Okay, use the rounder pencil and draw the figure. Don't draw in your hand it will be a wrong method. Okay, you draw the figure by using rounder and pencil. Next we have to consider at point on the surface. So when the point P lie on the surface of the solid sphere, then we have r, small r will be equal to r. See, the point is here. What is the distance? R. Now the point has been taken towards the sphere and consider exactly on the surface. So on the surface means we can consider just outside the sphere. The point which is just outside the sphere we can consider. Okay. So here R is greater than or equal to R. That means the point is on the surface. So here from this expression 3 we found that if R is going to be increased, the potential is going to be decreased, and if R is going to be decreased, the potential, the value of its magnitude is going to be increased mathematically. So here R varies from small r to capital R when the point P moves from here to here. So if it is so, then instead of R we can write capital R, right? No need to write these things. So for the point P which is lie on the surface of the solid sphere, then we have R equal to R, that means radius of the surface, and which is shown in the figure 2, then V will be equal to minus Gm by R will be minus Gm by R. Instead of R, we can write this one. So, it will be this one. Let it is your equation number 4. Now, we have to consider the point P which is inside the sphere. That means R less than R. Suppose this is the point which is inside the sphere. Then at this point, the potential will be how much? That we have to find out. For that, I am going to show you here. Let's see. This whole sphere is a solid, right? I'm going to zoom it a little better. This whole sphere is the solid sphere, right? Now we want to find out at this point the potential will be how much, right? So at this point you can see that this is the point which is on the surface of this solid sphere. Okay, this point P is situated on the surface of this sphere whose radius is small r, right? Okay, and then if I am going to remove this sphere, small sphere, then this point lies inside, this point lies inside other hollow spheres. See, this will be the one hollow sphere. If you have to, I have to consider this one will be another hollow sphere, this one also hollow sphere, this one also one hollow sphere. So up to, it will be move up to distance r as the radius is capital R. Okay, so that means this point is on the surface of this small sphere and this point is inside the for other cells. That means this is one cell, this is one cell, above that another cell, above that another cell. That means the cell's radius, if we are going to consider this is approximately R, the cell's radius starts from R and continues up to capital R. Understood? Again, this point is on the surface of this solid sphere. Okay. Now, this point is inside this sphere. If I am going to consider it, this will be the cell inside this cell. Okay, having the radius is R. You consider another cell here. Also, this point is inside this cell. You consider another cell, next cell. For all the cell whose radii is increases from small r to capital R, for those cells this point will be inside. So hence total potential at this point will be the sum of potential due to this solid sphere. Let this one will be V1, and potential due to all the cells whose radius starts from small r to capital R. Here to here is capital R. Okay, so except this sphere, others we have to consider the cells. Okay, so this will be one cell, this is another cell, this is another cell, this is another cell, this is another cell. So I can consider large number of cells. For any cell, this point will be inside, right? So first, this point is inside the cell whose radius is small r. Here, very similar with small r. Okay, and then this small r increases up to capital R. Okay, so this is the concept behind this, that we have to be derive the potential of the solid sphere at a point inside the solid sphere. Okay, so same thing it has been written over here. I'm just going to be read line by line, you just watch and carefully you have to write down in your note also. So when the point P lies inside the sphere at a distance r the from the center, then potential at point P due to solid sphere is equal to the sum of the potentials at point P due to the inner solid sphere. Inner solid sphere means this one, the dotted area. Okay, this is the inner sphere. Due to this inner sphere, this point is on the surface. So this will be the V1, first potential due to inner solid sphere. Let this is V1, in bracket you have to write V1, of radius R, and all the spherical cells means from the spherical cell starts from here, then cells is going to be overlap, and it will be increases, the radius of the cells is going to be increases from R to capital R. From R to how much? From this distance to up to this distance. Okay. And all the spherical cells outside it means outside the point, lying between R to capital R, as shown in figure 3. Okay. Now, the gravitational potential at point P due to inner solid sphere of radius R will be minus G, mass of the sphere of the radius small r, divided by R. So it will be volume into density. Volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho divided by r. It will be minus g 4 by 3 pi r square rho. It is your equation number 5. And this will be the V1. Okay. Now, to finding the potential due to cells for which the point is inside the cells, what we have to do, we have to write down in the general way, then we have to integrate. See, to find out the potential at point P due to all concentric cells, let us consider an elemental cell of radius x and thickness dx, for which P is an internal point. So this is your represented in figure 3. So to find out the potential at point P due to all concentric cells except this sphere I have been cutted out, okay. Now we have to find out the potential at point P due to all concentric cells. This will be one cell. For that, first we have to write the generalized way. Suppose this is a cell whose radius is x and thickness is dx. For this cell, this point is a inner point, right? Same thing it has been written, that let us consider an elementary cell of radius x and thickness dx. I'm telling about this one, concentric cell whose radius is x, thickness dx. For this cell, P is a inner point, right? P is a inner point. is an internal point, which is shown in the figure 3. Okay, now gravitational potential at point P due to this elementary shell of radius x will be how much? It will be minus g mass of the shell by the radius, because in our last class we have been discussed that if the point will be inside the cell, if the point will be inside a cell, particular cell, then at this point the potential due to the cell will be how much? Minus gm by r. R is the radius of the cell. So here, which cell we have been considered? We have been considered this cell, this shaded cell. For this shaded cell, P is a internal point. So for this shaded cell, what is the radius? X is the radius. So now for this shaded cell, at this point, the gravitational potential will be how much? Minus g mass of the cell divided by radius of that cell. So minus g mass of the cell will be nothing but volume into density by x, radius of the cell. So the volume will be nothing but 4 pi x square dx into rho, that we have been sorry yes 4 pi x square dx into rho, because here we have to consider this strip. Okay, if we are going to consider this strip, the area of this strip will be 4 pi r square and this width will be dx, so volume will be 4 pi x square into dx. If this will be the volume, I have to multiply the density, then it will be mass of this cell. Okay, so same thing it has been written, 4 pi x square dx into rho by x. So here x, one of the x from the numerator is going to be cancelled out, so it will be minus 4 pi g rho x dx. Okay, now carefully you have to watch. For this cell at the point which is the internal point P, how much we found the potential? We found that is your dV2 will be how much? That is your minus 4 pi g rho x dx. This much we have been found, right, for this cell. Now if you consider just this cell, just above this point, the cell which is just above this point, that means if we have to consider this cell, the radius will be approximately r, small r. You got my point? If we are going to consider this cell, for this cell potential at point, we found this one. Okay, now we have to consider a cell which is just above this point, means the point P will be the inner point of this cell, of this shaded one, of this cell, right, whose radius is approximately r. Is approximately r, or you just consider it will be r. I have to zoom in, it will be better. Okay, so just above this point, whatever the cell we have been considered, the radius of that cell will be small r, right? Then if it will be r, then for this cell dV2 will be how much? Minus 4 pi g rho r into dx, because here the radius is r and thickness we have been considered same dx. Now if we have considered another cell here, then dv will be, suppose we have to consider this cell, another cell over here whose radius is r1, then what will the potential? This will be 4 pi 0 r2 dx, like that. So now here we have been concluded that the potential at point P will be the sum of the potentials of this one due to this cell, then next cell, then next cell, then next cell, then next cell, up to how much we have to go towards the outside. We have to go up to the distance r. Okay, so this will be the first cell due to which the potential at point P, which is inside this cell, will be minus 4 pi g rho r dx. Then for the next cell, we are going to get the potential that will be r2 dx. Then for r3 radius, it will be r3 dx. That means simply we can say that at the point P, if we are going to find out the potential, then the sum of the potential of the all the cells. So in general, it has been written that minus 4 pi g rho x dx. So if I am going to integrate from this r to r, then we can get the potential at point P due to all the concentric cells. Okay, so that work we have been done there. So the potential at point P due to all cells, all the concentric cells lying between x equal to r to x equal to capital R can be found by integrating the equation number 6. That will be 0 to V2 dV2. This is minus 4 pi g rho is constant taken outside, r to r x dx. We just integrate, is very, very simple. It will be x square by 2. R to r, r is the lower upper limit, you just put, and we are going to find out the equation number 7. It will be 3 r square minus 3 small r square by 2. So this is the V2 we found for all the concentric cells above the point P. Above the point P, or we can say the point P lying inside the all the concentric cells, and what is the potential. Okay, and now the net potential will be, hence gravitational potential at point P, hence net gravitational potential at point P due to whole solid sphere is given by V equal to V1 plus V2. Hence net, if you have to write, it is already written whole. So here net, no need to write. Hence gravitational potential at point P due to whole solid sphere is given by V equal to V1 plus V2. Hence using equation of 6 and 7, we found, it is not 6 and 7, it is equation of 5. Okay, equation of 5 and 7. By using equation number 5 and 7, we found equation number 5 minus 4 by 3 pi r q rho, and this one is the 7. Here I have been substituted. Just take common as 4 by 3 pi rho g outside, it will be r square minus 4 by 3 pi rho g, so it will be r square plus 3 r square by 2 minus 3 r square small r square by 2. So it will be just a simple addition. Here you can see that this will 2 r square plus 3 capital R square minus 3 r square. So it will be 3 r square. Here it will be 2 r square. We can found 3 r square minus r square by 2. Here I have been multiplied r cube above numerator and denominator. So it will be 4 by 3 pi rho g r q 3 r square minus r square by 2 r q. So this is nothing but your, see, 4 by 3 pi r q rho is nothing but mass, total mass. So minus g m by 2 r q 3 r square minus r square. this is your total potential due to the sphere inside a point which is at a distance r from the center. Okay. Okay, now we have to consider some special case, very simple. At center of the solid sphere, also center of the solid sphere means that point is inside the sphere. So r will be 0, hence equation number 8 we have to put small r will be 0, means it will be gm r square by 2r cube, that will be minus 3 gm by 2r, let it is your equation number 9. And on the surface, on the surface, the small r will be capital R, so it will be 2r square. So gm 2, so here you can see 2r square by 2r cube, so obviously minus gm by capital R, minus gm by capital R, this is your equation number 10. Now from equation number 9 and 10 you can found that potential at center will be equal to 3 by 2 potential at surface. So hence potential at center by potential of surface will be equal to 3:2. The ratio of potential at center by surface equal to 3:2. That means at center the potential is larger, okay, which is greater than that of the surface. Okay. So center potential at center by potential at surface will be equal to 3:2, let it is your equation number 12. Now expression for gravitational potential due to solid sphere, just we have to put at external point, V external is nothing but minus gm by r, so E external will be minus d V external by dr, it will be minus gm by r square. Equation number 13, at point on the surface it will be r equal to r. So instead of here r, we have to put just r, so minus gm by r square, so equation number 14. And then at point inside the sphere we have to put v internal, that means minus d by dr of v internal will be this one, we have to put minus gm by 2r cube into 3 capital R square minus r square. Here we have to consider the derivative with respect to dr, means this will be r is constant, it will be 0, when derivative with minus r square it will be minus 2r. Okay, so it will be, so here minus minus plus minus, this minus also plus, here another minus, so it will be minus 2r. So we are going to get E external will be minus g m r small r by r cube. Internal. Okay. So E internal will be equal to minus G small r by r cube. And here you found on the surface gm by r square, external gm by r square. That means radius increases, means the magnitude of E is decreases. Here also distance increases, means the electric field intensity decreases gradually. And here also decreases, potential also decreases with increase of distance. Okay. And as r is constant, so E equal to minus gm by r square will be also a constant, corresponding potential also will be constant. And here for the inner side of the sphere, the potential also decreases. Potential also decreases. But and also your electric field intensity proportional to R increases. Proportional to R means increases. Okay, that means if we have to move from the center to towards the surface, then it will be increases. Okay, so here graphical representation of V with respect to R, E with respect to R, here I have been represented. You can follow these two figure correctly. You have to draw, okay? Draw these two circle by round or round pencil. So here you can see that at the center it will be wrong. I have written at the center it will be -3 gm/2r. So at the center -3 gm/2r. -3 gm/2r, and this side in decreases in the form of -gm/r³ 3r² - r² okay, 3r² - r² So here you can see 3r² - r² as, so from the center to towards the surface it is also decreases. You can see 3r² is a constant, so r is increases means the numerator decreases, so this is slowly decreases, but above the surface it is the decreasing rate is going to be increase. Okay, so this is the variation of potential with distance from the center, and this is the baseline where the potential will be zero. Okay, as it is negative, so it is approaching towards zero value. Okay, we can say the magnitude is decreases. If we are not going to consider negative sign, then its magnitude is decreases. But if we are going to consider the negative sign, then we can say then up to zero value. And here you can see at the point r equal to infinite, here see r equal to infinite, the v value is going to be zero. So it will be, so the asymptotic behavior it will, the value will be zero. So the magnitude, you just remember in the form of magnitude. Okay, the magnitude is going to be decreases continuously. So here the electric field, as I told, that from the center to the to the surface, the electric field intensity increases. As E proportional to R, I am considering only magnitude, increases, and the value will be -gm/r² on the surface of the sphere. Then above the surface, if we have to move above the surface means outside the points, if the point which is outside it is moved from the sphere, that means this r is going to be increases. If r is going to be increases, the u is nothing but e equal to -gm/r. Small r increases means the electric field intensity decreases. This is the magnitude decreases. When r equal to infinite, then the value is tends to zero. This side also same behavior. Okay, so this is the graphical representation of v versus r, e electric field intensity versus r, distance from the center. So this is all about your potential due to solid sphere outside, on the surface, inside. In detail we have been discussed, and graphical representation also we have been discussed. Write down this note carefully, and if you found any doubt or problem, you can contact with me. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.